I'm a senior for the country. Hey, girl. This is for real, too, by the way. This is, like, real. Here we go. Hey, girl. Come on now. You know you got everybody looking at you. Got a little broom in my big truck. Gonna open up the doors and turn it up. Gonna stand my boots in the Georgia mud. Gonna watch you make me fall in love. Get up on the hood of my daddy's tractor. Up on the toolbox, it don't matter. Down on the tailgate, girl, I can't wait to watch you do your thing. Shaking for the young bucks sitting in the honky tonks. It's the rednecks rocking till the break of dawn. The DJ spinning that country song. Come on, come on, come on. Shaking for the birds, shaking for the bees, shaking for the catfish swimming down deep in the creek. For the crickets, the critters, and the squirrels, shaking to the moon, shaking for the birds.
What's wrong with that song? Sounded good to me.
I mean, first of all, I can't do it that well, but okay. What's wrong with it is that it's a blast to kind of sing, because I learned it a little bit of it this morning, and it's fun to sing, and it's really catchy for sure. That's why it's like the number three best-selling single by a male artist ever. And it's Luke Bryan and his friend Dallas Davidson and him wrote it. So music and melody always takes precedent to me over lyrics. Like, in other words, you can hear somebody singing a song, they have no idea what it means, but it doesn't matter because it just feels good. So I think that that's something about this song, but I can't stand the lyrics. What's wrong with it is it's completely disrespectful to women. And to girls, this kind of talk is bullshit. Okay, and this is why. Because in this song, in no spot in it, does Luke Bryan say anything about this girl other than who she can shake it for or her looks. And he doesn't talk anything about, like, who she is. And it's also highly offensive because it's coupled with her shaking it for everybody, for every guy in the bar, for not only guys, but also wildlife. I just can't. It's offensive. Boom. Okay, so I'm not here to, like, bitch and moan for the whole video. Because when I watched the CMAs this year, I think it was last Sunday, maybe the Sunday before, I was so hopeful because I thought the lyrics have changed. I think the lyrics are changing. And I do think it's because women are more present. They were certainly in that show. And, you know, I'd like to see them more on the radio for sure, and more female writers getting cuts. But I do think that it's starting to turn a little bit. So, this is what happened. I'm watching the show, and Kelsey Ballerini gets up and starts singing this song called Homecoming Queen. Kelsey Ballerini's like 20-something, beautiful young woman, and she starts singing this song, and she gets to, what is it? The line about, what if you told the world... What if I told you the world wouldn't end if you started showing what's under your skin? When I heard that, I was like, yes, thank God. So this was hopeful. You can look it up. We'll provide you with a link down below in the description where you can read the whole lyric if you want to. We'll also give you a link to the song because it's worth hearing. Anyway, I heard that. Then I heard a song when I was at the gym called 10,000 Hours, which was actually written by, I think, all men. Yeah, so these guys, Justin, my BB, and Dan and Shay, who were, they won best vocal duo that night. And this is a song they wrote with Justin Bieber. And you know what? The reason I like it is because he's actually asking the girl, not telling her to shake it. And he's actually asking her like some pretty sweet things about herself.
Like what?
I like the line about, did you get your middle name from your grandma? Like, to me, that's like a nice boy that really wants to know about you, like as a whole person. Shake it, baby! So that's why I like that. Okay, so then I saw that show. I was all excited. Casey Musgraves sang, and what a beautiful voice. She won Best Vocalist. Anyway, I saw all these women. Dolly was there. Reba kicked ass. And I was really hopeful, and I still am. But then I went to the gym, and I was doing my leg presses, which I don't enjoy. And then I heard this next song by Luke Combs, who was at the CMAs, won Best Vocalist of the Year, and I think he won Best Song. So let's just listen to it. This is Luke Combs with One Too Many.
But I can't turn it off once I turn it on. There's no stopping me once I get going. Put a can in my hand, man, I'm wide ass open. The tick-tock of that clock is like a time bomb. By half-past 10, I'm half-past 10. At quarter 12, man, I done had plenty. The countdown's on and the first beer hits me. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, too many.
Okay, here's where it gets in trouble.
After 5 dying millers, I was feeling loose. Slinging karaoke to a TL2. When a pretty little thing shot me awake, she said, hey, cowboy, could you buy us a drink? Well,
just listen to him. First of all, it's hilarious because, like, Luke Combs clearly loves to drink. And it's funny to me, this lyric. But then he's got to bring in the ladies, and he calls a girl a thing, and I have a problem with it. We are not things, and just knock it off. And I think that Luke Combs, too, I think he's better than this. Like, he was conducted himself like such a gentleman at the show, and a lot of his stuff is great. But this one, I just want him to consider that he's better than this lyric. So once again, like, you're freaking out because the music's so fun, it's so high energy, and then he's got to call a girl a thing. And I don't like it.
In a baby doll.
In a baby doll. Oh. I just think language is important, and I've had people tell me, like, you shouldn't get so upset. It's just words. Well, words, you know, like, they came from somebody just, like, grunted out a word once, and it was an expression of a feeling or their perception of the world. And so I argue that it's important, and I also have hope that things are changing, that maybe we won't be called things much longer, and maybe we won't all have tiny little hands and tiny little heads. I want to put a positive spin on all of this by giving you a challenge, and that is to take this Luke Combs song and rewrite the second verse for me. I want the line about tiny little thing and baby doll when referring to a woman to be changed to something respectful to women. The first person who rewrites that verse and sends it to me, or actually put it in the comments below, you can do it any way you want to, just get me that lyric. First person who sends it to me who I think has accomplished the goal of the challenge gets free tickets to my December 21st show at GAR Hall or a show in Nashville, Tennessee. Be sure to click the link below to my tour page. Links are there for the lyrics, so you can hear or read all the lyrics for the Luke Combs song. Also watch the video. Take the challenge, change the song, and let's be good to women and to men. Here we go. Girls, girls. bird.